Hello, you lovely ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mangus, and today I welcome you guys back to Unit Analysis, the series where we take a look at units from Advanced Wars in great detail. And in today's episode, we are finally taking a look at the glorified water missile, the carrier. Yes, the biggest meme in Advanced Wars. This unit right here is so silly, but I love it to bits. Every time I see a carrier being built, I get very excited, even though it's a ridiculously silly unit. Yeah, I think the carrier was a futile attempt at the developers. It was kind of like a response to the imbalance between air and naval units. They clearly looked at Advanced Wars 2 and they were like, wow, naval units really suck. We need a better unit to combat air units with, because the cruiser clearly isn't doing its job very well. And they came up with the carrier. The only problem is they slapped way too high a price tag on it, because I think they were worried about upsetting the game balance too much. So they figured, if we just add expensive units to the game, they probably won't upset the game that much. And as a result, you almost never see carriers being built. Maybe if you play high funds on Advanced Wars by Web, you might see a carrier or two. And sometimes you might actually see a carrier being built in a competitive match. And in fact, I want to start off this video by showing you guys a little bit of a clip from the Advanced Wars Grandmasters Tournament, because something very unexpected happened there. And if you saw it, I think you know exactly what clip I'm going to show you. This is from the quarterfinals. It is Sif versus Toulouse. And you can see here that Toulouse was pressuring Sif a lot on the right-hand side here. He had a bomber, which Sif didn't really have a response to. And he was going for the HQ, which was completely exposed. And he was playing Lash at that. And Lash is very good at HQ capping. And then something completely unexpected happened.
It doesn't work. It's 26. So it can still transport.
That's both.
He can get two infantry. He needs to get something on the HQ. Oh, he's got a carrier!
Shitting me. No way.
Did he mean a battleship and misclick?
No way. He did what? Not. I refuse to believe this.
Holy shit.
What?
Whoa, it protects everything.
Oh my god, what?
And Sif actually went on to win this match. I wouldn't say the carrier was like the sole reason why he won it, but it certainly bought him some time, because Toulouse was not able to cap his HQ. So that was an incredible match. If you haven't watched the Grandmaster Tournament, I'll throw a link to it in the video description. You definitely should watch it. It had some really cool matches, and we actually saw a carrier being built. I can't get over that. I can't get over that Sif actually built a carrier, and he wasn't even high funds. So yeah. The carrier, oh boy, let's have a look at its basics, shall we? First of all, you know, as I said, it is primarily an anti-air unit. It can only attack air units, but it does have the biggest range in the game, 3-8 range. I mean, that is incredible. If you play a CO like Grit, for example, you can see a carrier cover the entire screen. So it is good at fighting air units, but is it worth it for the price of 30,000? Well, that's, most of the time that answer is no, it is really not worth it. Even though you get a unit that can zone out almost half the map. And one of the reasons I would say why the carrier is so bad at what it does, I think it has one huge weakness that, in my mind, makes it practically unusable. And that's the fact that if you have a bomber right here at the edge of the carrier's range, the bomber can still get within the carrier's minimum range, like this, and the carrier can do absolutely nothing to stop it. Now the carrier has to move away and it will get hit by the bomber next turn unless you have a cruiser capable of protecting it. And this will happen 100%. If you build a carrier in a non-fog of war match, your opponent will respond with a bomber if they have an airport. And that bomber will seek out the carrier like a beacon, and the carrier can't really win against the bomber one-on-one, which is a huge weakness. So if the carrier just had one less minimum range, this weakness wouldn't be there, and that would probably fix a lot of the issues with the carrier, well, aside from the fact that it costs way too much. But this alone, in my mind, makes the carrier almost unusable, because the one thing that it's supposed to do, protect itself versus bombers, it doesn't really do that unless you have some external help, and that is a huge problem. Now, let's talk a little bit about the carrier's basics aside from that. It does have some hidden qualities to it. It actually has pretty good vision. It has 4 visions. As you can see right here, it does scout a big part of the map on its own, so it's not completely blind. It's not like the battleship, which requires external scouting support. It also has a very nice source of fuel and ammo. 99 fuel, 9 shots. It does not require resupplying. It can last a long time out on the battlefield, even against CEOs like Drake, which will fuel drain it. So the carrier is pretty self-sufficient. And not only that, The carrier also has a support function. Like the cruiser, it can store two air units aboard its ship, and it is not just limited to transport copters and battle copters like the cruiser is. It can even store fighters, bombers, stealth fighters, and even black bombs. And while doing so, it will resupply the units on deck fully. So the carrier can sort of work like a mobile harbor that can resupply air units with fuel. It doesn't repair them, but it does resupply them. So with black bombs and stealth fighters that are very reliant on their fuel, it can sort of help them out in a pinch. You can also protect them from enemy air units, which can sometimes be useful in high fun matches, but it also kind of steals a turn from the units themselves, because when you deploy the air units, they do not come out ready to move like they do in Days of Ruin. And I will make a separate video on the Days of Ruin carrier, believe you me, it is a completely different unit. It requires a video on its own. But yeah, it can do this, and I wouldn't say it's super useful, but it's there. There have been a couple of situations where I have played where I found this useful, but yeah. That requires a carrier to actually be on the field, which is a big investment in and of itself. So, let's take a look at the carrier's damage value, shall we? I mean, it is primarily an anti-air unit, so let's see how it actually deals with air units. So, against battlecopters, it does 150% damage, and I'm actually kind of surprised by this. I actually thought the carrier would deal more damage than a missile. But it turns out that this is actually not the case. And as always, guys, I know I'm gonna get some comments if I don't point this out. I've turned powers off, so here, even though I am playing as Drake, the carriers are not at any extra strength. So yeah, against the battlecopters and transport copters, the carrier does 150% damage, which is as much as the cruiser, I believe. So I'm actually kind of surprised by this. I was always under the impression that the carriers would do a lot more damage, but no, their firepower actually isn't that great. Against fighters and bombers, they actually do identical damage to the missiles. So when I call them glorified water missiles, this actually isn't a joke. They may have more range than the missiles, but their damage values are actually very comparable to the missiles. So that means that if you're up against a CO with a small defense boost, like Combi for example, you actually cannot one-shot air units with the carrier, which is honestly pretty ridiculous. Now against stealth fighters, they do the same damage, 100%. So again, their damage is completely identical to that of missiles. Now I did screw up my order a little bit right here. I was gonna show off the damage versus a black bomb, but it is 120%, in case you guys wanted to know. So offensive-wise, I would say that the carrier is actually kinda underwhelming. It means that if the carrier has taken a little bit of damage, or if you're going up against a CO like Javier, for example, the carrier actually won't do as much damage as you might think it does. Especially for the price of 30,000, I would say its firepower is actually very low. Just a bit disappointing. Now, let's talk a little bit about the carrier's defenses. Before I start that, though, I would like to say one thing. I've read in some comment section, I think this is a little bit of a myth. Some people say that the carrier can detect submarines. This is a lie. As you can see right here, it is sitting duck against submarines. It cannot see them, it cannot attack them, it cannot counterattack against them. So I don't know who kind of started spreading this myth. I've seen it a couple places on certain message boards. This is not true at all. But let's take a look at the carrier's defenses, shall we? First off, how does air units perform against them? Battlecopters do 25% damage, so you know, this is kind of the same problem as the cruiser. Although I will say that in Dual Strike, the cruiser is actually a lot more resistant to battlecopter fire. But I would still say that battlecopters do pretty well against carriers. They can't get within its minimum range without being shot down. So you can zone out battlecopters with carriers, but if they get close, they will do nice damage to you. Stealth fighters do 45% damage to carriers, so again, this is a pretty good engagement. And of course, the carrier cannot hit the stealth fighter while the stealth fighter is hidden. Bombers, as we discussed earlier, is a pretty good counter to carriers. 75% base damage, and they have the ability to get completely within the carrier's minimum range. So bombers hard counter carriers. Carriers cannot respond well to bombers at all, which is kind of disappointing. Now, as for other naval units, battleships do 60% base damage to carriers. So, you know, if you can get a battleship within the carrier's range, the carrier has to move back. Submarines are also a very good counter to carriers. They do 75% base damage, so they're really strong at taking down carriers. God, I love the sounds of Dual Strike. Don't you guys love the sounds Dual Strike makes? And Cruisers can attack carriers, but they only do 5% base damage, so unless you get a little bit of luck, you probably won't see them doing much in the way of damage. Rockets do 60% base damage to carriers, so carriers are pretty vulnerable to ranged attacks. Again, you don't really want them too close to land if there are indirects popping about. Artillery does 45% damage, which is not, may not seem like a lot, but when you think about the fact that this cost you 15,000 right here, it sure doesn't seem great. And of course, the almighty Pipe Runner does the same damage as that of a rocket, I believe. So, then again, I don't think I've ever seen a Pipe Runner attack a carrier. And just because I like showing all the damage values, let's take a look at how ground units perform against the carrier. The tank deals 1% base damage, so even with luck damage, you're not going to see a whole lot here. Medium tanks do 10% damage to the carriers, which is not a lot. The Neo tanks deal 15, I believe. So most tanks are not really going to hurt the carrier all that much. However, the Mega Tank actually does a lot of damage, 45%, so the Mega Tank is so ridiculously overkill that it even deals damage to naval units, which is kinda interesting. But yeah. So yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about the carrier. It's a big meme unit, probably the biggest meme unit in Advanced Wars, but I like it, and I love building it, and I love utilizing it. I really like the undervalued units in Advanced Wars, and whenever I see them, I get very excited. And it does feel good to actually build a carrier and use it to some effect. And I will say that on certain high funds map in Advanced Wars Spy Web, they may have some application, although maybe not too much. They're very niche units, let's just put it that way. However, I believe that if the carrier was maybe, let's say it cost 18,000 and had one less minimum range, I actually think it would have been a lot more useful. Anyway, guys, what do you guys think about the carrier? Do you like it? Do you hate it? And how would you go about balancing the carrier for competitive play? What do you think would be an appropriate price tag for the carrier? And do you think it should be able to do more things? I think, personally, that for such a price, it should also be able to attack submarines. I think that would have been a very good thing. But yeah, let me know about in the comment section what you think about the carrier, and let me know what units you would like to see me review next. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, give me a like, comment, and subscribe for more Advanced Wars content. I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.